Welcome to Game 5 for the Reading B Rockets. The boys lost a tough one in a very evenly matched affair last week with Drakett. That game could have been decided by three fumbles lost by the Rockets and even just one or two plays. What a great game. Hey, for the third week in a row, the Rockets will be facing an unbeaten team in Chelmsford. Now, the Rockets seem to have their way with this team in the preseason, but a whole lot of things can change in 5 weeks, and this Chelmsford team is on a roll. So one kid I need to mention this week, Sean Beckenhuis. It appears I miss at least one big tackle, which Sean's been a part of every week, BBH.
Right.
You know, another kid I need to mention, Keith Richmond. He made a number of big plays this week, and maybe the biggest of all, a huge fourth down sack. He didn't make it on camera. I'm calling you out right now, BBH. It's the greatest play of the kid's defensive career, and you missed it.
It happened.
So I don't want to blame you, Brian, but I will.
All right. So lastly,
we talked about some kids who needed to step up last week given the absence of Stephen Webb and Dante Barboza. No one did that better than number 11, Jeremy Roche. He made play after play on both sides of the ball, including a tremendous strip on the final scoring drive. Would have sealed a victory for the Rockets if they pounced on it. But the Rockets look to get back on the winning track this week. They're still without Stephen Webb, but Dante Barboza is back. And I think we're missing Andrew Hattery this week, too. So a couple of guys are out, and the kickoff's coming up. All right, Chelmsford set for the kickoff here. Back deep is Dante Barboza, number 7, Troy Pollock. Pollock injured his thumb pretty good last week, too, but he's got it wrapped up, and he's ready to play. And here we go. It's a squib kick there. They've got to jump on it. It doesn't go 10 yards, though. That's going to be a flag, so that's going to be good field position for the Rockets. Tried a little squib kick, and it didn't quite go the 10, so Rockets are going to take over first down with excellent field position here. I'm not sure why we had to re-kick that one, but we're going to re-kick and reset the clock and start it again. I don't know if the refs were ready on the other side. Fortunate break for Chelmsford, I think.
No doubt about that.
That's a better kick there right now. They better pounce on that. It's a live ball right there. Picked up by Dante. He gets wrapped up almost immediately, but still going to start out with excellent field position on the Chelmsford 40. Absolutely awesome day out here, BVH.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Beautiful, right? This is the type of day we need to put some sunblock on.
No.
We got a couple of Chelmsford guys up here. We're going to get some we'll get some color commentary from these guys up here. Assuming they don't kill us, we're surrounded by Reading. And so, all right, it's going to be first and 10 for the Rockets. Let's see if they start with a steady dose of 24. Lucas Fleming, he's been a beast all year. And Lucas is in there. He's got Sean Beckenhuis back. Fleming in the shotgun. It's a low snap, but Lucas takes it. He's got a little bit of room ahead of him. Wow, keeps driving the ball. Lucas takes it for about probably 6 or 7 on first down, almost to midfield. So nice start for Fleming. As the Rockets are known to do, they swap out quarterbacks almost immediately. Number 22 is in there, Dan Damari, and Sean Beckenhuis, 41, in the shotgun. Direct snap to Damari, follows Beckenhuis. Danny cuts it up and gets pulled down after a short gain. So very close to midfield here, but probably a yard short of the first down. We're looking at third and short with Reading. All right, third and short here for the Rockets, right close to midfield. Looks like Fleming back in there again. Lucas takes the ball, and oh boy, he's got some room, and he just drives it for an extra few yards too, so Fleming's got the first down and more to the Chelmsford 42. Rockets switch out quarterback again. It goes back to Damari and Beckenhuis in the shotgun. It's a direct snap to Damari. He follows Beckenhuis, and Danny's got some room. Nice cutback, he still drives it ahead. Very close to the first down, I think he has it. So, great job by Danny on a couple of cutbacks. He's been one of our best runners all year, PBH, right? One of the most natural guys. He sees up the field beautifully, and Damari takes that for a first down, and they flip-flop, and Fleming comes in now. Fleming in the shotgun. He keeps it, he falls back, and he's... Lucas tries to get outside. He's got some pursuers on him, and they do a nice job to wrap him up. He still grabs a couple of yards here over the 30-yard line. So The Rockets with a steady dose of Fleming and DeMario moving the ball well here in the first series. Hey, up here with a couple of Chelmsford fans. I'm looking for some insight on the players. He's like, I'm here with the cheerleaders. I don't know anything. All right, we'll take that, though. First down here, Harrigan in there. It's a handoff to Fleming. Look at the hole he has. Wow. Fleming takes that for an easy 10, 12. And Lucas and Damari alternating carries here and alternating first downs, and we're inside the red zone. All right. Andrew Ficino runs out to the ball. Fleming in the backfield. Patrick Harrigan under center. Harrigan hands it off to Fleming again. Why not stay with it? It's been working. And he drives it inside the 15-yard line. So, BVH, listen, we might not get any insight on the Chelmsford players, but if we need to know anything about the cheering squad, I get some ace guys up here. Yeah, it's good to know. All right, so it's going to be second and about five here. Eye on you. All right, it's going to be second and five here. Harrigan under center, Fleming back, Beckenhuis as well. It's another handoff to Lucas. He's got a little room on the right side, and he just bowls ahead as he's known to do all year, and he gets inside the 10-yard line. So great series of downs here for the Rockets, and they get another first down. This is going to be now first and goal upcoming early in the game. All right, first and goal here for the Rockets. Harrigan under center. It's a handoff to Fleming again, and Lucas puts his head down and drives in. So, wow, what a dose for the Rockets there. Beautiful start for Redding, and they march right down the field and score. And Fleming and Damari, the ones carrying that, mostly Fleming. You know, I talked with Fleming's dad this year. He said he wasn't going to play football this year. How about that?
Wow.
He's been such a big kid, he's had to play with kids who are 2 years older than him. And until this year, they finally caught up with him, and that was a great decision. Right now, the Rockets are going to go for two here with Jeremy Rosh kicking. Number 11, and what a game Jeremy had last week. Both sides of the ball, he was awesome. It's a snap to Pollock. Oh, it's a low kick, and it's not going to make it. But we talk about Jeremy Rosh. Let's stay right on him and do a player profile, BVH.
You got it.
He's played really well this year when asked, and his favorite male celebrity, Aaron Rodgers. This is Brady country, buddy. I don't know what he's thinking about. We'll forgive Jeremy. You know why? Because his favorite food is, and his quote, bacon with a side of bacon topped with bacon. Huh?
Nice.
Gotta love that. Listen, little known fact, BBH, first documentation of bacon, 1500 BC by the Chinese. Wow. In a recent poll, 23% of men rated bacon as their favorite fragrance.
Oh, there you go.
My daughter gave me a tube of bacon balm, lip balm that's bacon flavored.
Nice.
A few things about Jeremy. His favorite place was also the fridge, and he sent that survey to me a month ago. So he's not copying Patrick DeRoss. I just didn't get to it yet. We'll come back to Jeremy in a sec as Lucas is going to kick off here after the Rockets score. 6-0 early on. Lucas can really boom the ball. And he does. That's a nice kick back there. Fielded nice by number 23 for Chelmsford. He gets spins out of some trouble early, but gets picked up by Sean Beckenhuis and number 11, Jeremy Rosh, right? So Jeremy says he also wanted to be a panda. A la Pat Dwyer. I wonder if they have bacon-flavored bamboo. Huh. The superpower we'd like to have? The ability to have any superpower. Huh? It's getting a little cerebral with that one, huh, Brian?
Jeez.
Yeah, your head's going to explode thinking about that. It's like the old genie, right? Give me three wishes, and the third wish, give me three more wishes.
There you go.
But Jeremy was awesome last week. Single-handedly almost won the game for the Reds. Let's see what Chelmsford has to offer in their first offensive series here. That big defensive line for the Rockets in there with Fleming over the center. Watch him. In the shotgun, two split right. It's going to be a pass almost immediately, and it's a, wow, what a pass. Beautiful pass and catch. And Jeremy's going to bring him down. He's going to cut right. Wow, what a play, and he's in for the touchdown. First play from scrimmage. What a pass. And now, you know, I talked with Coach Dan Webb about this. They said Chelmsford loves to throw the ball, and that kid can sling it. And a beautiful play getting behind Rosh. Nice cutback.
His, the long ball.
All right, hey, the insight up here is watch the long ball now. I don't know. Listen, that's 2020 hindsight up here. Wow. Some cutting-edge color commentary by the guys up here. But needless to say, we heard that they like to throw the ball, and they showed it right there, and the Rockets have had trouble with that in the past. A few games, too, defending the pass. So Wow, talk about a quick strike answer. And they're going to try for two right here with a kick. A little trickery on the play here. Let's see if the Rockets can get in close. Gets in there, and it looks like they're going to miss it too. So, wow, one play from scrimmage, and it is a 60-yard-plus bomb for a touchdown. They missed the kick as well, so early on, it's Reading 6, Chelmsford 6. How about that, BVH, getting right into it? I think the Rockets knew that they could throw, and there they go. That kid would really sling the ball. So, well, it looks like we're going to have a fun game here. Well, a long sustained drive for Reading to score and a single play for Chelmsford to answer back. Quick counterpunch by Chelmsford to tie it up. And we're right back at it here. Back deep is going to be Pollock and Barboza again. That's a nice kick right there. It's going to go to Troy. Troy feels it, cuts one way and cuts another. Finds a little seam and rushes up the middle, so he gets it to about the 44-yard line. That's where the Rockets will take over first and 10. Let's see if they continue with the steady dose of Fleming. Pollock's going to take over a quarterback. Andrew Hattery is out today, so they put my boy, number 54, Dan O'Connor, in the offensive line. Under center, it's a handoff up the middle, and that looks like Damari. Damari stays on his feet and drives her for about four, maybe five. So let's call it second and five upcoming. Here we go. Let's call it second and five here after the carry by Damari. Pollock is under center. Wonder how that thumb will work. First one worked out fine for him. It's a hand of, oh, it's a keeper. Oh, it looks like Barboza cuts up. Usually you see that play, the inside handoff, try to sweep it, but Dante cuts up. He gets about maybe three, and it's going to be third and two coming up. Here for the Rockets, just over midfield. In the shotgun, we have Pollock. We have Damari behind him. In motion is Sagala, 40. Oh, we get some movement on the line there, and it looks like it's going to move the Rockets back 5 yards and turning this thing into a third and seven. So, unfortunate move for the Rockets there, and we're going to reset, tacking on five more yards to the negative. All right, it's third and seven now after the penalty. Stevie Needham in the middle at center. It's like a similar play here. Troy's going to keep it and follow. Oh, boy, nice cutback for Troy, and he gets the first down. That's a beautifully set up play. You see number 40, Sagala, cut in. Damari cuts in right behind him, so he's following two blockers there, and Troy weaves his way through for a first down. So nicely set up play there, and the penalty doesn't hurt the Rockets. All right, we said number 53, Stevie Needham, in there in the center. He's going to be our next player profile. In motion, looks like a similar play the other way, and it is the almost identical play. Troy cuts back, and he gets about maybe three or four. So, hey, talking about Stevie Needham, right? Stevie's favorite food, fish.
Nice.
I love fish. How about you? Adam Lee Hooker here, he could eat a tuna by himself. The guy's massive. They're 18, you know? His favorite celebs, Patrice Bergeron and Alex Carpenter. Nice. Know who she is?
Good one.
One of the best women's hockey players in the world up at BC right now. We'll come back to Stevie in a sec. It's going to be second and four or five. The 39-yard line of Chelmsford. Pollock in the shotgun. We've seen this play three times in a row. This time it's a pitch out to Damari, and he gets outside. They're calling a flag. Might have called a holding, and Danny's still on his feet. He gets a big gain, but I think this one might be coming back, and it is. Hold on the line there. I'm not sure who that was, but it's going to make it second and 15 upcoming. Getting back to Stevie Needham, right? His favorite movie, The Mighty Ducks. I think we got to remind Stevie he's on a football field out here, not the hockey rink.
Yeah, right.
His superpower he wanted to be? Flying.
Nice.
We've had a couple of those, BVH.
That's a good one.
Yeah, a little known fact about flight, BVH. In some countries, pilots are required to eat different meals in the event of poisoning. You imagine?
Wow.
Yeah, seeing that, I don't think that's ever happened before. You know, the odds of that occurring about the same as Coach Damari walking past a buffet.
Yeah, that's a good one, yeah. I don't know if that will ever happen.
No, that has also never happened, right? No one's ever been poisoned in the cockpit, and no Damari has ever walked past a buffet. So now it's second and probably 15 here for the Rockets after the penalty. Pollock is going to pass here. Oh, nice rush, and Pollock does a nice job to evade it and gets outside, and Troy turns nothing into something. Broken play. He was looking to pass it, and good pursuit by the defense on Chelmsford there to push him, but Troy turns that into a net positive gain of about maybe six, and it's going to be third, and I think it's third and 11 right now. All right, third and call it 11 here for the Rockets, maybe a little bit more than 11. Pollock is in the shotgun with Damari with him. In motion is Sigala again. It's going to be, oh, it's a keeper, and it's now it's a push to Damari. Unfortunately, the play guy took a little bit of a stumble there. Troy was thinking of going up for it with it, but he decided to pitch it at the end, and nice job by the defense for Chelmsford to snuff that one out and actually push him back.
Brings out a big fourth down now.
Yep. Down play here. They are over midfield. Looks like the Rockets may set up for a kick here with Fleming. He's been known to kick here, but don't put a pass on him to actually run a play here. Ooh, nice kick by Lucas. Gets it off, almost a perfect spiral. Great bounce, too, so it's going to push him inside. Number 15, Harrigan, dives on it. Probably doesn't have to, but nice job by Patrick, and that's going to put Chelmsford way back inside the 7-yard line. So great move by Redding to kick away. Beautiful kick by Lucas Fleming. He's doing it all today on the Rocket side, and it's going to be first and 10 for Chelmsford from their own 7. Let's see if obviously not afraid to throw. They've had one play from scrimmage, and it was a 60-yard bomb for a touchdown. Let's see if the Rockets learn their lesson. What's up, buddy? How are you? Hey, number 43 is Dante Barboza. Little player profile on Dante. Happy to have him back this week after being out last week. He's a pizza guy, too. His favorite male celebrity is Jamal Charles. Get a load of this. His favorite female celebrity? Wait for it. His mother, Kathy. I don't know if Dante's pulling some Eddie Haskell type stuff there, but I actually have inside sources that Dante, his mother Kathy, actually filled out his survey for him. So why not? You're not going to fill it out. I'm going to put me in there.
Right, there
right?
you go.
I tell you, Kathy, I think she won a prize at the Reading Social last week. You know who else won a prize? Mandy Harrigan, team photographer, best dancer.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to get back to Dante here in a little bit. Yeah, you should have seen Harrigan on the dance floor. We go fourth down, and it's going to be a kick here. And this is the wind is tough, too. I don't know which way it's blowing. I'm looking for a flag. Oh, it's hiked over his head. And this looks like it's going to be a safety. Wow. Wrapped up immediately by number 43, Barboza, number 21, Richmond. So the bad snap for Chelmsford pushes him through the back of the end zone. It's going to be 2 points for the Rockets.
And they'll get the ball back.
That's one way to get the lead back here. Yeah, and they're going to have to do a free kick from the 20-yard line here, and the Rockets are going to get the ball back. So, wow, big push there, and that penalty proved costly for Chelmsford as that hike pushed their kicker back, and Rockets are going to get the ball back with a 2-point lead here. Okay, the wind actually blowing right in our face, but this is going to be a big kick for number 55 here, kicking off from the 20 because of the safety, and it's a beauty. Wow. Beautiful kick, and they needed it. Pollock fields it back at the 30. Let's see if he can follow Dante. Nice block by Dante, frees him for another 5 yards. So Pollock gets it back to about the 45-yard line. But that was a beautiful kick by number 55, and they needed it. So the Rockets are going to start with good field position, but nice job by the kicker there, and nice run back by Troy. It's going to be first and 10 from their 46-yard line of the Rockets. All right, first and 10 here for the Rockets. We got Fleming in the backfield. We have Beckenhuis as well. Barboza split right. It's a directed Lucas. Lucas cuts back. He gets met immediately by a couple of guys, but still drives it for two. Takes about four guys to bring him down, but Lucas, it's going to be second and 8 coming up. Patrick Harrigan back in there at quarterback. I see Coach Dave Swanson walking by up front. It's a handoff. Oh, it's a sweep to Rosh, and he cuts back up. He sees the hole. I think Jeremy might have liked to take that one wide. He might have been wide open, but he saw the hole and drove ahead for about 5 yard lines. So interesting little trickery there, and Jeremy cuts it up for about 5. It's going to be 3rd and 5 upcoming, maybe 3rd and 6. 3rd and 6 here for the Rockets, right at midfield. Harrigan is in the shotgun. Damari next to him. Goes direct to Damari. He's going to follow. Lucas. Lucas takes it for 5. Very close to the first down. He's going to be probably a foot short. But he's very close to a first down here. You probably see the Rockets go for that short, being in Chelmsford territory.
Oh, yeah. 4th and 1, you got to go.
That's the type of color commentary we need out of you, BBH, right?
Go for it.
Okay, here we go. Harrigan is going to lead them in this play here. Look for Fleming, another dose of Fleming up the middle, right? Sask and Harrigan, they're talking to each other. Beckenhuis, fullback. It's a keeper for Patrick, and he gets stacked up, but he's got enough for the first. So it's going to be a first down, QB sneak for Patrick. And the Rockets are going to have a first down. So nice job there, and a new set of four for the Rockets upcoming.
Running to number 15, Patrick Harrigan. Tries to run up the middle. Instead, he runs into number 61, Shane Sutherland. And number 31, Javi Erickson. It's just enough to get ready for the first down.
First and 10 for the Rockets. We have Fleming back deep. Beckenhuis. Harrigan under center. It's a pitch back to Fleming. Nice job to hold on. It was a little bit behind him, but Lucas has some room in front of him. Cuts ahead and dives for about, let's see, another maybe call it 5 or 6 yards for Lucas there. It's going to be second and four upcoming just inside the 40-yard line of Chelmsford. Second and call it a long four here for the Rockets. The Rockets have actually held the ball most of this game with longer sustained drives. They're doing it again here, up two. It's a handoff to Lucas. Cuts back and he drives ahead. He's very close to the first down. I think he might have it. I think he does. So Lucas moves that thing up ahead and the chains move again. So one of these chains, this is very similar to that first drive, Brian, the first scoring drive. Long sustained drive, ripping off 4 or 5 yards in a run. And, you know, nothing secret about a heavy dose of Fleming and running backs here.
That's right.
Here we go. It's first and 10 from, let's say, the 32-yard line.
Take away the one play from Chelmsford, and it's a Reading.
It's a handoff to Fleming. Oof, he's met immediately there, but tell you, Lucas doesn't mind hitting people, and number 21 comes up to beat him, does a nice job to take him down, and it's going to be second and call it nine. All right, second and nine here for the Rockets. Patrick Harrigan under center again. Familiar lineup, I formation with Fleming back deep. Watch for Rosh on the wing, number 11. It's going to be a pass here. Oh, he's wide open as Barboza. Oh, he almost makes the catch, does he? Oh, wow. Almost an athletic play by Dante, and he was wide open out there. He's just underthrown, and Dante almost makes an athletic move to make that catch and just drops it at the end. But, wow, beautifully set up play. And I tell you, someone missed an assignment on Barboza because he was wide open. Just underthrown, so nicely set up play, just not executed, and it's going to be third and nine upcoming. All right, third and long here for the Rockets. This is probably four down territory being that deep, so Fleming right behind Harrigan. Ooh, what's happening here? Oh, he sets it up underneath. It's a nice play to Jeremy Rush, but also well defended. Number seven pulls him down after a short gain. So we're looking at fourth down here, but I would expect the Rockets to go for it inside the 25-yard line. And very close to the 25-yard line. Hard to see out here, Brian, with the glare.
Yeah, it's definitely tough to see on pass plays.
Yeah, so that was a nicely set up play, but a nice job by number seven out on the wing for Chelmsford. The wind's whipping up here, Brian. It's going to knock me over. Fourth down, and the Rockets are going to go for it here. And actually, it looks like a, call it a five, fourth and five. In the shotgun, looks like Harrigan. It goes directly to Fleming, and Fleming needs to cut up, and he drives forward, and he got the first down and more, I think. Beautiful play. Nice awareness by Lucas. He looks like he's in a scrum for the ball on there, but Lucas takes it, number 61, and him fighting for it, but Lucas knew where the first down marker was, and now we're inside the red zone right here for the Rockets. Nice play, fourth and five.
Just running the first down.
First and 10 here for the Rockets. Hard to see what line they're on. Just inside the 20, I think. And it's a handoff to Fleming right. What a hole. It is huge. He cuts back, and Lucas isn't going to be denied. Is he in? He is very close to the goal line. They give it to him. Oh,
no,
looks
he's
like
down
he's
there, like
down about the 3 yard line from here. Eagle Eyes Van Horn, BVH, doing it again for me. Wow, what a huge hole for Lucas there, and he cuts it in. It's going to be first and goal, maybe the 3 yard line. 2 minutes to go here in the, is that first quarter?
First half, I think, yeah.
First quarter half. Or first half. They say the first quarter, but I think we may be
getting close to halftime.
I think we may be getting close, but we'll see. Let's go. It's going to be first and goal here Damari back deep this time behind Beckenhuis. It's a handoff to Danny, and Danny goes off to the right. He gets pulled down almost immediately, so he doesn't get in, but he gets about a yard. It'll be second and goal upcoming.
Reading number 22, Daniel Damar with the carry. And he's brought down by number 61, Shane Sutherland. Second goal.
A yard and a half here. Same setup with Damari back deep. Oh, the ball gets snapped, and he might get jumped on here. That's a fumble on the snap, and let's see what they go. The Rockets lose it on the 1 foot line on the snap. And that is a killer for the Rockets. Which would look like an assured touchdown upcoming with three more chances there. They muffed the snap. And they turn the ball over. So they are going to be pinned back deep, but this is what killed the Rockets last week, was not taking care of the ball, and they lose it again here in a pivotal moment right here that could have put them up 14 or more, and now they hand the ball back over. So, wow, huge play. Nice job by Chelmsford to jump right on that ball. Usually you see a muff snap, and the quarterback has the best chance at it, and he didn't. And the Rockets turn the ball over. It's very deep, tough spot for Chelmsford here, but obviously not afraid to throw the ball, so look for him to do it. Can't afford to have any bad snaps here like they did the last time, because they are back deep again. But huge play for Chelmsford to get the ball there. Snap, hard to see where that ball is. He's wide open on the right, number 23. Dante comes over and pushes him out, but he gains, probably gets a little bit of breathing room there, and probably picks up maybe 6 or 7. And it gets him out over the 10-yard line, so nice play on first down for Chelmsford. It's going to be second and short here for Chelmsford. The number 23 gets him a little bit of breathing room. Hard to see from this angle. Number 11's under center for this one. One guy back deep, and it's a handoff to him. He gets cut immediately. Let's see who came in there. Number 22 is Damari. I think he actually pushes him down for a loss. We've seen Danny do that a lot. If there's a hole, he comes in from the linebacker position and closes it quick and pushes him back a yard. So it's going to be 3rd and 3 instead of just after the 2nd and 2. Nice job by Damari.
3rd and 4.
This is a huge play for Chelmsford right here. They need to get a first down. They don't want to be seeing 4th down from inside their 10 again. Under center, number 11. Looks like he's set up to pass, and he does throw it out, and it drops short. Nice coverage right there by Rosh, and Dante was out there too, so looking for number 55. He's their kicker, and it's going to be 4th and 3 now, and they might be looking for another kick here. He can boot the ball. He's shown that he's done it. He's given them good field position. You might have to see that play here because they certainly can't turn the ball over at the 10. Be a gift right back to the Reading after the Reading gave them a gift on a turnover. So let's see what they have here. Want to make sure that the snap is executed right, and let's see if number 55 can kick this one away. Troy's back, but I don't think he's back far enough. This kid can boot the ball. There we go. Now Troy backs it up to about the 40, 35-yard line. Number 55 takes it. He does kick it. Ah, it's a little bit of a squib. Maybe Troy doesn't need to go pick that up, but he does. He takes it for about 5 or 6 yards, so the Rockets are going to have excellent field position here. So nice job for the D. Credit the D to keep them in there. But took some time off the clock here. I don't know if that's the end of the if that's the end of the first quarter. It's one of the slowest quarters I've ever been involved in my entire life. Maybe that's the half. We'll see. That could be the first quarter with the Rockets leading 8-6 with awesome field position here just about the 22-yard line coming up. 10 here for the Rockets. Let's see what we have. We have Pollock. Is going to be in the shotgun, flanked by Damari on the right. Barboza's outside that Sagala in motion right now. We've seen that play a couple of times. Troy cuts back, and he's got some room there. Troy's still on his feet. So nice job for Troy. He's going to follow both Sagala and Damari. He cuts it back himself and gets a little bit more than 5, I think. So probably doing a time check right here with the referees, but it's going to be 2nd and 5 upcoming. Call it 2nd and 5 here for the Rockets. Pollock is going to be in the shotgun, flanked by Damari behind him or to the side of him. There's Sagala in motion again. We've seen this play a couple of times. This one's a pitch out to Damari. It's a quick one. Danny gets around the side. Nice job, and he finds a seam, and he dives forward. So, uh-oh, we get a penalty here, too, at the very, very tail end of the play. Let's see what's against. Looked like someone might have stuck his foot out and tripped him. I'm not sure how that works, but let's see how this penalty goes. Easily enough for the first down, but it looks like the ref is calling something. We'll see what it is in a sec.
We definitely have some flags out there. It's a holding call.
I didn't see that one, Bri. They called holding on Redding, so they're going to bring it back after the first down run by Damari.
Yeah, I didn't see anything on that.
I saw a leg kick out at the very end. I thought that's what might have been the call. They brought down Damari with a leg. Here's Sagala in motion. This time it's going to be a pass, and he's set up there, and underneath is Dante, and he makes the grab. He makes the catch. Beautiful play by Dante. We talked about what a great athlete he is. He's very close to the – he's got the first down, but he's inside the five-yard line, so – another little bit of underthrown pass there, but credit to Barboza, the athlete, dives for it and brings it in. So don't think he hasn't made a difference. We missed him last week, right?
Oh, yeah.
Now it's first and goal for the Rockets here. Are we looking at the time check? Fortunate to be up 8-6, but they'd like to make it 14 or more right here. 22 seconds to go. First and goal. Look for Damari and Pollock to work together here. Sagala in there as well at fullback. Under center is Pollock. Oh, it's going to be a pass here. Troy spins out. He throws it. Oh, he's right there. I don't know what happened. I think it gets intercepted. Oh, boy. He throws it up, and I don't know. Dante was open there, but the couple of guys closed on it. And was that ball intercepted? It may have been. The Rockets are going off here as if they've turned the ball over, and they have. Oh, two huge, costly turnovers inside the 10-yard line for the Rockets. And this one right before the half.
Yeah, that's the half right now.
And that is an absolute killer for the Rockets. They had an opportunity to put a stamp on this thing, and this game is a lot closer than it should be right now. The Rockets letting them hang around, turn the ball over twice inside. Hey, it's one thing to turn the ball over, Brian. Another thing to do it inside the red zone, much less the 10-yard line. And the Rockets are going to feel a little bit of pain there. I guess they should be happy. They're up 2 points right now. The defenses look great with the exception of that very first play. And it's halftime here with Redding, 8, and Chelmsford, 6. Danny, Damari, and Jonathan. Here we go. Rockets set to kick off here the second half. It's a squib kick right there. That's a live ball. It's picked up by number 7. Nice block right there to take for 5, and he gets wrapped up immediately. Number 51 is Kenyon in there, and let's see who else is in there. Number 15, Harrigan. So we start the second half here with the Rockets up 2, and they could be up a lot more. They've sort of dominated this game, certainly in terms of time of possession they have, and they've had some long sustained drives that they've turned over inside the 10-yard line. And once again, the bounce is not going the Rockets' way this week, but the defense has played very well since that first pass. This is going to be probably Chelmsford's best field position since the very first play of the game. So it's first and 10 here from the, it's called the 38.
For those of you that didn't get over to the Snack Shack Fieldhouse at halftime, you got a lot of fresh food over there right now.
Number 21 in motion under center. It's 11. It's a pitch this time. Number 7. Wow. Gets pressed in. Nice cutback there. Gets crunched by Danny Junta at the end. I think it was Damari in there that he got around. So nice play there to get around him, but he gets wrapped up by Danny Junta on the wing, but he rips it off for about 7. Second and 3 upcoming from about the 44-yard line. It's a nice run on first down. The Rockets have done very well on the run all day. They rip off 7 in that play. Under center, number 11. 21 in motion from the other side, and now it's a pitch the other way to 7. He gets tripped up almost immediately. That's number, Damari comes flying through there from the linebacker position to trip him up, and it looks like it's about no gain, if not a loss of one. So it's going to be 3rd and a long 2 coming up. 3rd and 3 upcoming here. I say 3rd and 2, long 2. Tightly stacked formation, this one. One guy, two guys in the backfield, eye formation. It's going to be a pass here. right underneath, and wow, I don't know if a defender or the receiver, number 55, turned around. He tried to throw it underneath, and it's going to be a fourth down here. And fourth down hasn't proven too well for Chelmsford early in this game. Fourth and two, so this is a huge play here. You may see them kick. Number 55 can really boot the ball, but in a game of field position, you may see them kick this one away. But fourth and two could leave the Rockets with excellent field position. Looks like they are. Chelmsford coach is imploring them. They got 10 seconds on the play clock here, and they are going to go for it. It's going to be a pass, and he heaves it up. Oh, looks like back there is Troy. Troy intercepts the ball, and it's a great athletic play by Troy. Oh, boy, looks like we may have a block in the back here. That may have been a play Troy wished to let go over his head, right, Bri?
Oh,
a fourth down play. He does run it back close to where the line of scrimmage was, but I think we might be moving him back on a block in the back. So on a fourth down there, great athletic play by Troy that the Rockets may have benefited from if he just let it drop. We turn the ball over on downs, and the Rockets are going to take over first down, but with some maybe a negative 20 yards on that play. So Rockets get the ball back, and nice setup play on that first series of downs, though.
Oh, yeah.
So they did the defense did a nice job after a 7-yard gain. They stopped them. Pollock intercepts it, but they're going to do a block in the back and move them way back. First down for the Rockets here. Troy Pollock is under center after the interception. They're going to take it first and 10 from their own 24-yard line. Adam Deema rushing in on the line. Didn't have enough players on the line there. They got to get the snap off quickly. He does. He hands it off to Damari. Damari cuts right. He's got some room. Nice play by Danny. Cuts up and drives it for a first down. Well, the ball's on the ground. Wow, the ball was on the ground, and Barboza pounced on it. So Damari lost it. I don't know if he was down, but they get an extra 3 or 4 yards there. Nice play by Dante to pounce on it. The Rockets are going to be first and 10 at their 42-yard line. So about a 23-yard net positive gain for there, but the ball went on the ground again, Brian. This time the Rockets are fortunate to pounce on it.
Very lucky.
All right, first and 10 here for the Rockets after the nice run by Damari. The opportune pounce by Barboza. It's a handoff to Fleming. Oh, wow. Number 61 gets right in the backfield and drops Lucas for a loss. So beautiful defensive play there, cutting right through that line. And it's going to be second and 11 upcoming. Call it second 11 after Fleming gets wrapped up in the backfield. You don't see that too often. Troy's under center, and he hands it off to Dante, who has to make a neat move just to avoid a tackle. And wow, two great defensive plays by Chelmsford here to move them back. There was actually a guy right in Dante's way on that inside handoff, so he had to cut up and cut right into a Chelmsford defender, and that pushes him back even farther, so it's going to be third and probably 15 upcoming. Two great plays by Chelmsford. Third and 15 here for the Rockets. Looks like we have Damari and Pollock. Pollock's in the shotgun. He moves Beckenhuis over to the right. Beckenhuis in motion. Looks like Troy's going to follow both Beckenhuis and Damari. Troy does a nice job to get outside, but he gets strung out and gets pushed out of bounds. Or just pulled down just in bounds. It's going to be fourth and very long here on the 40-yard line. You might see them have Fleming boot this one away. So fourth down here for the Rockets from their own 30-yard line. You may see Fleming put his foot to this one. Lucas had a great first punt here, but it looks like they're not. Looks like they're lining this up for a play. I don't know if he's going to kick it. He may kick it right behind Pollock. Pollock moves and he does kick it. Good kick, actually. Bounces back to about the 35-yard line. Gets picked up by number 21. He's got a little bit of room ahead of him. He's got a lot of room ahead of him. And he gets picked up, finally pushed out of bounds by Fleming. But a huge run back for Chelmsford. Goes right up the seam there. Picks it up and runs it back to inside the 30-yard line. So the Rockets can't convert. They get pushed back on second and third down. Nice kick by Fleming, but the special teams play right there. He runs right up the seam, and it's going to be Chelmsford with beautiful field position here. 7 minutes to go in the third quarter. First and 10, Chelmsford. Looks like we have him in the shotgun here. Oh, it's hiked over his head right here. Let's see if he does. He does a good job just to hop on it. Matt Sagala was all over him, so the hike actually pushes him back almost 15 yards here. So a tough snap over the head of number 8, and it's going to be second and forever here. We call it second and 25. That's one way to move the ball for positive yardage for the Rockets. Going to try that play again. It's going to be a pass here. He's a lefty here, and there's Jeremy Ross. Oh! Jeremy cuts behind it, hits him in the chest. He almost picks that one off. So Chelms are not afraid. They got righty throwers. They got lefty throwers. They're throwing everything at you. But a nice pass, actually. Nice job by Jeremy. Just hit him in the chest. And Jeremy had nothing but green in front of him there, too. But it's going to be third and very, very long here for Chelmsford. Oh, boy, there's a flag down, and they're calling it against the Rockets. And that looks like a 15-yard penalty. Looks like roughing the passer they called on that one. Wow. I don't know if that was our boy Fleming who got in there and put a lick on him, but they protect the quarterbacks, especially at this age, too. So roughing the passer gets them right back to an automatic first down with the original line of scrimmage. So huge penalty against the Rockets. Cancel out those two big pushbacks right there with that penalty, and it's first and 10. Number 8's going to sling it again right across the middle. Wow, beautiful-looking pass, but it looked like the receiver took the wrong route there. Nothing but the white of the Rockets back there. Slings it across the middle, and maybe that was just a miscommunication on the route there. Call it second and 10 upcoming. Second down and 10 here. The PA announcer announcing the Kobe Beef Burger is coming up. I see BBH frothing at the mouth right here. Oh, it's up over his head again, but it looked like there's actual motion. So nice athletic play to stop that one, number 8, but they're going to move him back. They're going to make it second and 15 with movement on Chelmsford's side, and we'll reset that one. All right, second and 15 here for Chelmsford. A couple of penalties moving these offenses back in the opposite direction. That's a nice snap. Number 8 slings it out. He throws it over the head of number 55, and Dante was right there, got his hand on it. So it's going to be third and very long upcoming. That little guy, number 8, throws a nice spiral, isn't he, Bry?
Yes.
You're still thinking about Kobe Beef Burgers.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's stop paying attention, okay?
I know.
Getting distracted. Easily distracted, BVH up here. Anytime the wafting smoke and food and grills happen, we lose you, don't we?
Yep.
Hey, speaking of that, let's, while we have a little, I guess we're not going to have a timeout. They're just pumping us up here with some Dropkick Murphys, but third and long coming up here. Look for number 8 to be slinging this ball. The wind's whipping a little bit right now, Bry.
Yeah.
Big number 55 is in the backfield, the I formation. It looks like we have now called timeout. So timeout after that. And let's see if we can find our buddy number 22, Danny Damari. Let's look for 22. Hey, Dan is the son of legendary and longtime forever assistant coach, Big Dan. Dan's a J.J. Watt and an Alex Morgan fan. And his favorite food, BBH? Steak.
Nice.
Right? Can you imagine the Damari family ripping into some nice 96-ounce porterhouses?
Huh? There you go.
Yeah, there's rumors that Big Dan and his four boys actually go out late at night to hunt. Yeah, yeah. Take down a couple of cows, maybe, right?
Sure.
They probably could. I think Big D could do himself. Hey, listen to this one, BVH. Dan's favorite movie is Ted. Who
there
else was that?
Derek.
Yeah, your kid.
Yeah.
So needless to say, we got to talk to you and Dan Damari about inappropriate viewing of hilarious movies.
Movie.
But who knows? He says the superpower he'd most like to have is to know things before they'd happen.
There you go.
I don't know about this, BBH. You know I dabble in philosophy, right?
Oh, yeah.
That's a very difficult one, right, to have because it begs the question, if you know something's going to happen before it does, is your goal to alter those events? Or what if you knew what they were and you couldn't change them?
Yeah,
some deep stuff
good.
Right here, huh, BBH?
That wouldn't be good.
All right, here we go. It's going to be third and long here.
Come on now.
I smell something burning. I think it's your brains, BBH. Here's a handoff right here. Big number 7, and he gets wrapped up immediately. Number 30, let's see, is that 22 is Damari. That's our boy Damari right in there. Number 54, Dan O'Connor in there as well. Yeah. How about that? Having that power could be more of a curse than a power, huh? You know what's going to happen in advance? I think we just opened up a wormhole right here, didn't we?
Yeah.
I bet if we ask Double D again, he's probably just going to say, I just wish I could have a steak anytime I want it.
Exactly.
Yeah, we like to raise the bar here, BVH.
Yeah, sometimes.
We like to challenge our viewers, too, all 10 of them.
Yeah, exactly.
Fourth and long here, but you're probably going to see four down territory. These guys aren't afraid to throw the ball. The 32-yard line, not going to gain that much field position. Here's going to be a pass. Number 14 goes back, and he heaves it up. Oh, no, it's not looking right there. It's number 41. Oh, boy, he doesn't turn around, and that's going to give you the flag every single time. It's well defended. Not the greatest pass. We've seen better ones, but it's going to be an automatic first down, and the Rockets are going to get penalized here. Unfortunately, Beckenhuis didn't turn around. If he did, he was well defended, but anytime you don't turn that head, they're going to call it automatically. And this is going to be great field position. Huge fourth down conversion on a penalty. And that one's going to hurt the Rockets. First and 10 here for Chelmsford. Excellent field position after the big penalty. Pass interference. Oh, we got some motion. Looks like, wow, it's penalty central here now, Bri. This game's not is looking less and less like a football game with each snap. And the flow of the game is actually slowed down quite a bit. A lot of penalties. I don't think they're actually ready for them there, so they might just be replaying first again. I think we had our linesman wasn't quite queued up there, so let's redo first. Number 14 back in the shotgun. He's the guy with the big arm. He's going to look left. He throws it underneath. Oh, it gets tipped. Tipped by Harrigan. A little bit of a duck there, and Pollock was right there but couldn't collect it. So it's going to be 2nd and 10 upcoming from the Rocket 15. All right, 2nd and 10 here. Calling in a play. Number 14 looking for the play call from the coach. It's a big defensive series for the Rockets here. It's a beautiful pass. He's wide open, number 21, and he misses the ball. Wow. Rockets very fortunate there because number 21 got behind defenders Rosh and Pollock, was wide open, and the ball went through his hands. So beautiful pass by number 14, and just didn't finish it off. So
that sun is tough. He was looking right into that sun.
You know what? I think you're right, BVH. It's a brutally tough sun looking that way. So kudos to you, BVH, huh? Stepping up, trying to help the kid out. 3rd and 10 here. It's going to be another pass this way. He slings it wide open. Wow, what a catch. Harrigan's all over him, but he's right on the goal line. He may be there. Beautiful pass and catch. It's at least a first down, and they're on the 1 foot line. So set up perfectly there, and there was great coverage from Barboza, and he tucked it in there. So the pass has been the thing that's really been a tough thing for the Rockets to handle all year. And we got 4 minutes to go. I don't know if it's in the third. It looks like we're 4 minutes in the third. It's 8-6 Rockets, but it's first and goal here from the 1 yard line for Chelmsford. Under center for this one. It's a handoff to number 7. Oh, he gets hit immediately by Richmond to slow him down, and Danny O'Connor comes in and cleans him up for a pushback. So nice job by Richmond to slow him down. And Oki crushes him from behind. It looks like now they're counting the number of players, and there's a flag. I think we have hopefully too many guys on the field for Chelmsford. The Rocket players are cheering. We'll see what this one is. And it is against Chelmsford. I think they had too many guys on the field for that particular one. You see the ref counting, and it's going to push him back. So that one hurts, pushing back 10 on first down. Call that a 5-yard penalty, still a pushback, but I tell you, the penalties here are stopping momentum on both sides of the ball. It's going to be first and goal from the 6 now instead of the 1 foot line. Under center again, now he goes to 7 this way. Wow! Who came in there? It was Damari. Came untouched and rips him down for a loss. Now we're looking, pushed him down almost behind the 10-yard line. Danny Damari, we're just talking about him.
Yep.
He must be smelling the steak, too. He smelled a Kobe beef burger over there. Get all fired up.
Exactly.
Great play by Danny there to push him back. It's going to be second and goal, but actually outside the 10 now. This is a typical passing formation for Chelmsford. We've seen this one before. It's going to be a pass again. He rolls right. Oh, boy. Oh, but I think that was, who was that there? Was that Dante?
Yep.
Dante had a chance to jump that route, went right through his hands and couldn't convert, and that would have been a huge play for the Rockets. Wow, they needed that one, right? But Dante just couldn't make the play. The ball a little bit underthrown, so he covered it well. And it's going to be third and goal from the 12-yard line now.
Very sloppy and undisciplined football, Tim.
Yeah, I think so. You know, really on both sides of the ball, too. It's the game's taken on a whole different tone with the penalties and the missed opportunities. He heaves this one up. Number 21's there, and he pulls it in. So Jeremy Rush couldn't quite get on him. He tried to turn it around. He throws it over his head, and the Chelmsford's going to take the lead here.
So reminiscent of last week versus Draken.
Well, it's reminiscent for the sake of some Rocket miscues
that
are leaving these guys in the game.
Yep.
And there's plenty of time left here, Brian. But this right now is 12-8. Let's see if they try to kick and make it 14. But the Rockets haven't been on offense in a while. And we'll see what comes up here with this kick. Kick attempt here, and this is a big one. Two will make it. They have to get a touchdown. If they miss it, oh, let's see. Does he get it? Nope, he misses it. So that's a huge play for the Rockets because now they are within a score right now, 12-8. And so one touchdown will put the Rockets up ahead. That safety might prove more important than we thought, Bri, later.
Yeah,
but
right.
Let's see if the Rockets can rally here. It's been a little bit of ugly football the last few series on both sides of the ball. And a couple of miscues are leaving this team in after the Rockets commanded the whole first half. Field position and time of possession. They owned it. And yet here we are, and they're trailing by four with 3 minutes to go in the third. Guy Chelmsford to kick off after taking the lead after the nice pass and catch. It's a beautiful kick. It's going to go to Troy. Troy's going to catch it, and he's going to try to follow Rush. Troy with a nice move. What a straight arm he puts on this guy and rushes it for another 10 over midfield. So great run back by Troy at the very end. He puts his hand out a la Earl Campbell, straight arm to the face, and gets another 7 yards there. So listen, he's showing no ill effects from that thumb hurting him at all. I think he put his big wrapped up thumb right in that guy's face, Brian, and he takes it over midfield. So listen, the Rockets have excellent field position here, and I think we're going to see Pollock right back in at quarterback. First and 10 here for the Rockets. Back to the old familiar Fleming behind Beckenhuis. Troy hands it off to Fleming, and Lucas goes right. He gets dragged down, though. He gains only about 1 or 2 yards here to the 45, so nice play by Chelmsford. They're starting to do a better job on the run here, which should help them. So call it second and 8. Second and 8 up coming here. We got Jeremy Rush split far right. Fleming in the eye. It's another handoff to Fleming. He's got a big hole, and oof, gets hit hard by number 51, but drives him for a few yards. It's going to be probably third and about 3 coming up, so nice run by Lucas. Maybe not the best spot we saw right there for Fleming, so call it third and a long 4 now. It's a handoff to Lucas again. Lucas goes off the side. He drives this one forward. Feels completely content to put his shoulder down over number 23 and lets him know I'm here for a first down, and Lucas drives it ahead. Another steady dose of Fleming here, which worked very well for the Rockets early in the game, and it's a first down. Here for the Rockets, 36-yard line, excellent field position. It's going to be a keeper for Troy. What a block by Fleming. He's still out there, and Troy's got a ton of room in front of him. Wow. Lucas came out front and put a lick on him, opened up a huge, huge set a pasture right in front of Pollock, and Pollock takes it for a first down. Great run, but That one was keyed by the block by Lucas this time. First and 10 here for the Rockets. Right at the red zone. They've had trouble converting in the red zone. It's a handoff to Lucas. He pushes off left, and wow, he's still on his feet. Lucas is still going. They can't take him. He might roll this thing right down to the touchdown. Wow, I lost him there, Bri.
Wow.
Lucas went off tackle. It was hard to see him, and they could not pull him down, and he rips it off for 20 yards. So right when I tell him they're having trouble in the red zone, Lucas runs it in for a touchdown to put the Rockets back on top. So real quick answer here for Reading. It's just what they needed. Nice series of downs. Nice run back by Pollock. Big run by Pollock and Fleming. Huge block by Fleming. And then Fleming takes it himself for 20 yards. He was not to be denied there, right?
Yeah, he was all set there.
Well, he's carrying half the Chelmsford team with him on that last one. So the Rockets hop back on top here. And let's see if they're going to go for one or two. They only need one to keep it within make it a three-point game. And they are going to go for one. Why not hand it to the big man again? And there he is. Fleming is in, so the Rockets go for the one there. That's going to make this game 15-12. And that's a huge extra point right there too, Bri.
Yep.
So the Rockets reclaim the lead almost immediately, and that's what the type of football we're looking at here. Got a little ugly in that third quarter, the end of the second quarter too, but that's the type of football we're accustomed to seeing, and a great run by Lucas for Reading to take the lead again. The Chelmsford PA announcers over here just begging for some coffee, right? So they get it. What a great field up here, Brian.
Yeah,
huh?
Beautiful.
Beautiful field, beautiful day, you know, and they get the old PA out
music
here cranking. Music's cranking. What's the tune that gets you most pumped up, Brian?
Maybe a little gonna
hear
Welcome
something?
To the Jungle, maybe?
Oh, yeah. You know that one. You're a Motley Crue fan, too, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Most of those
my
ones.
Hat, maybe.
What's that?
A little kickstart in my hat would be good.
Wow. You're bringing up some serious 80s hair metal right there. I like it. All right, so, hey, Fleming is going to kick off here. The Rockets regain the lead, and they answer quickly. But, hey, this team is clearly tough and resilient, this Chelmsford team, playing much better than we saw them play in the preseason. They are certainly not afraid to sling it. They might even throw it more than the Wakefield team. Nice kick by Lucas. Picked up by number 7 around the 20-yard line. And he gets, oh boy, he gets wrapped up immediately by the number, let's see, 52 is Andrew Fatino and 51 Zach Kenyon. 51 and 52 put the lick on him there, so nice job by Kenyon and Fatino. So nice to call Andrew's name too. He's quick, he's one of the guys you'll see on the outside taking over for Stephen Webb defensively. And he's looked good replacing Stephen, who's a tough guy to replace. Let's see if this big Rocket defensive line across the middle, we got Sagala, we got Oki, we got Fleming. Richmond on the outside. Big Danny Junta's in there as well, so they've done well, but I tell you, defending that pass, I'd like to see those guys get in and maybe put a little bit more of a pass rush on them.
Yeah, gotta get some pressure on them.
All right, first and 10 here for Chelmsford coming up. Let's see if they can answer. All right, here we go. We got Troy Pollock is back 35 yards here deep. Sort of defending that pass. He moves up a little bit closer now. They're under center for this one. And it's going to be a rollout. And he looks like he's got a little room this way. Here comes Harrigan. Oh, boy. Fleming, or Danny Damari comes in, puts a lick on him from behind, and so does number 40, Sagala. So looked like maybe a plan play to roll out, but there was no one there for him to pass to. And they actually pushed that one back. So nice play by Damari and Sagala on that one. And in comes number 52, Fatino, just like we talked about on that right end.
Yeah, Sagala left hurt too. I think he's hurt.
I think Matt Sagala was shaken up on that play. That's why Fatino comes in. Second and call, 13, under center. This one's going to be a handoff to number 21, and oh boy, he gets wrapped up immediately by Oki, and then a couple of guys come in to help him out. Number 41, Beckin, he's number 22, Damari, so great play by Oak right there to hop on his back, and that fools no one and pushes him back another yard. So there we are, pumping our boys' tires again, Bri. Right?
There you go.
Okay. Hard to peacock in these tight stands.
Though. I know. Hey, listen, we're really making it happen up here. Where they don't have a press box up here, so we're doing a balancing act. Oki wearing the bright pink socks for breast awareness month here in October. You see some of the players on Chelmsford doing the same. Third and call it 15 here. Nice play by Oak to push him back. That reverse doesn't fool anyone. This one's going to be a pass. There's already people moving. He throws it. It's a beautiful pass over his head. Wow, almost pulls it down. Penalty. Troy was in good position, but I think they're going to call motion here and move him back.
Yeah.
Couple guys moving, and it's going to be – they may wonder if they're going to call this one, make it third and forever, or so they can make it – was that going to be a fourth down? It looked like they called it immediately, so they might just replay.
Yes.
Or I think they're going to wave it off, and they're going to make it fourth and long here. Let's see what the call is.
Yeah, illegal shift. Redding declined it, so
yep.
Fourth down.
And now it's going to be fourth and 15. But they're set up right here to throw. Number 14, their big kicker's not back there. They're going to go for it here. And they do. And he heaves it across the middle. Oh, wow, he can throw the ball, huh?
He does have an arm.
He's got a beautiful arm. He slings it across the middle. But this is going to be a turnover on downs. It's going to put Rockets in unbelievable field position. I will say this, the wind is right in their face, too. So a kick might not have been an option for these guys. And he slings it across the middle just ahead of number 32. That kid can fire the ball, huh? Like to see him on the mound in Little League. I'm sure that's what he does in the spring.
Right.
But this is going to be a turnover in downs, and the Rockets could really put a stamp on this one here with really unbelievable field position here. This is a song that'll pump you up, BBH, right? Little AC/DC, Thunderstruck.
Oh, yeah.
That'll get you fired up. Yeah. Troy Pollock under center. It's a handoff to Fleming left. Lucas keeps driving the ball. I tell you, they saw Lucas on the last time he had the ball. He carried half the team into the end zone. Lucas takes it for a first down inside the 20, so here we go. Last time I was a little critical of their execution inside the red zone, and they scored a touchdown, so what do you say we do it again?
Exactly.
Second and 5 here for the Rockets. This is a steady dose of Fleming behind Beckenhues. May see that inside handoff to Dante, too. That's a pitch out to Fleming. He gets outside. He's still on his feet. He's got the first down and more, and Lucas dives over the 10-yard line. So Lucas rips that thing for about 12. He's inside the 10. Nice pitch by Pollock. He led him perfectly. So those are some of the things they've had some problems with execution. Some high pitches are behind them. That was a beautiful one by Troy, and it looks like that's the end of the quarter here. That'll be switching sides. The Rockets 15, Chelmsford 12, and the Rockets on the doorstep one more time. Clock is all messed up here, so the Rockets are going to get it first and 10 here. Stay on that same side of the ball. I thought they were switching sides. We're looking at the clock of the field. It's a handoff right here. Fleming, again, he cuts back, and Lucas very close. Oh, no. The ball's on the ground, and they fumble it again inside the 5-yard line, and the Rockets are really hurting themselves here. Three fumbles inside the 5-yard line. They're about to go in and put a stamp on this game, and Chelmsford comes up with it. Wow, that is frustrating. So Fleming goes in. It looks like he lost the ball. It was hard to see where he lost it, but the Chelmsford players came up screaming with the point the other way, and they have the ball. It's deep here. They're within 3. It says 4 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter now. So we got a few minutes left in the game, and we just handed the ball back to them. So the defense is going to have to come up big yet again for Redding. All right, here we go right now. Fumble again inside the 5-yard line. The Rockets lose it. Big number 14 can sling the ball. Look for him to do it right here. He goes back to throw it, and he throws it outside. Oh, boy, beautiful play by Dante to knock it away. So number 55 was out there. We know that number 14 can throw the ball, but Dante comes in and knocks it down. It's going to be second and 10 from the 2-yard line, and they're going to need a big stop right here, the Rockets. All right, second and 10 here. These guys look content to be throwing the ball this deep. They're going to do 2 more shots of this thing. Big task for the Rockets. He swings out right now. He throws it underneath. Oh, nice. He drops the ball. So nicely met right there by Sean Beckenhue. So it was a good throw. Looked like he had it. And Sean met him right when it hit his hands, and he drops it. So third and 10 here, and this is a huge play for Chelmser because although with 4 minutes to go, you don't know if you'd want to go for it on fourth down. They did last time from the 30-yard line, turned it over. But now they're inside the five. That's going to be very difficult. Very difficult call in fourth down. So this is a huge play right here for the Rocket defense. All right, here's the play right here. Look for the pass. Oh, it's a bad snap. Oh, wow. And is that another safety? Wow, a low snap gets pounced on. Sagala went right in there. Number 21, Keith Richmond, was in there. And that is a killer right there for Chelmsford. Looking for a very big play and attacks on two more points for the Rockets. But guess what? That only makes it five. So with all this stuff going, I tell you, got a little bit of a sloppy game, and the Rockets have been fortunate. Terrible time to have a bad snap when they're going to get the ball back here with 4 minutes to go. I don't think they can be content with sitting on this thing. They need to go down and punch in a score.
Yep.
So the free kick is going to go off again from the 20-yard line, which should give the Rockets excellent field position. But once again, it's three turned over balls, and these ones even hurt even more because they're inside the 10, and the Rockets haven't been fortunate with the bounces. But they are fortunate to be up in this game, 17-12, and they're going to get the ball back. So let's hope that they put the pedal to the floor right here and see if we can get one more score. You don't want to be within a touchdown with these guys. Right there's number 11, Jeremy Rosh picks it up early from the 40 to the 35. He cuts outside. Jeremy's got room. Oh, there's Dante coming in. He pushes him outside of the 20-yard line. So what a run back by Rosh, and the Rockets are going to take over. Once again in the dreaded red zone.
Yeah.
They were great 2 times ago, not so great last time, but there's 3 minutes and counting. Unfortunately, you can't trust these game clocks.
Yeah,
I don't think they've got to trust the clock in the field. So we're getting to the last few minutes of the game here, and let's hope the Rockets try to push one more in and put this thing out of reach. First down here for the Rockets. Looks like Pollock in the center. We are on fire up here too, BBH.
Yeah, yeah.
The sun is kicking out here. There's a handoff to Fleming left. Oh, he's got a lot of room. He just gets tripped up. Nice play over there to catch him, number 32. Oh, and then we got a flag down. And let's see what this one's all about. Man, a lot of flags in this game. And let's see if there's going to be a block in behind. But Fleming rips it off for about 7, and we got an injured player. We're going to take a little time out here. Hey, number 14 is Jonathan Grady. We got a little bit of a timeout here. Jonathan's favorite food is pizza, and his favorite celebs. A recurring theme here, BVH, Gronk and Taylor Swift.
There you go, two good ones.
Jonathan's favorite movie is The Interview. What about that guy? Was it about the guys heading to North Korea to take out Kim Jong-un? What about the haircut on that guy, huh? Kim Jong-un?
Love it.
You know what he needs to do? He needs to go to Coach Masucci's barber.
Yeah,
he goes there once a week. Masucci looks fantastic. Well, we have a big penalty, personal foul on Redding, which is going to push them back to second and 20 now. So the penalties have been killing the Rockets.
Undisciplined
the fumbles
football.
Have been killing the Rockets. And, you know, hey, it's second and 10. There's a few minutes to go, but the Rockets would love to get in, and now they call timeout. So, hey, listen, getting back to Jonathan, his favorite food is pizza, right?
Nice, good one.
What's, you love pizza?
Love.
You pizza guys down in Georgia, Adam? Oh, big. You know what, I like the brick oven stuff, right? Yeah, I'm going to plug Bertucci's, right, because those are the Bertucci's guys bring it to the snack shack. But, hey, I went to pizza.com because that's what I do, right?
There you go.
And it says we consume over 251 million pounds of pepperoni every year.
Oh, I bet.
How about that? Hey, can you guys guess the top five pizza delivery days each year? See if you guess them. That is number one, Super Bowl Sunday. Another one?
New Year's Day.
New Year's Day number two. Look at you guys, huh? Three more. What do you think?
It's all football. That's right.
Listen, three, four, and five, Halloween. The night before Thanksgiving and New Year's Day. The sixth biggest, any Friday night at Coach Beckenhuis's house.
Big, nice.
Here we are, second and long. Cindy McGrath just came up here with a hamburger. She's taunting us. Oh, it's a pitch to Lucas. He cuts up. He's got a seam. Lucas does a nice job to hold on to the ball that time. And he drives it back almost the original line of scrimmage, so it's going to be maybe third and 11 coming up. It's certainly four down territory here, but the Rockets, they get it's getting late on the clock now, Bryce, so we're not sure what we actually have here.
Yep.
But there looks like another timeout on Chelmsford. They want to stop that clock. So we'll see a third and long coming up. Cotton Eye Joe out here, Bry. I saw Minimum Play an article writer, Joe Dwyer, just slapping his legs there, doing the Cotton Eye Joe next to Webb. It's going to be right behind Pollock. Look at a big room there, and Jeremy Ross seals it off. Lucas has got the first down and more. Oh, boy, now they're calling. Look at this. We got a looks like a penalty here. Why don't you get these guys off each other here? Number 61. There's a little brawl here, and Pollock telling him not to touch anybody. Coach hops on. Wow, what a crazy play there. Some extracurricular activity with Sean Beckin, who's in the number 61 after the huge run down to the three-yard line. We got an adult there wearing black and white watching from 3 feet away. How about getting involved? Huh? It's okay. You got a front row ticket to a brawl between two 12-year-olds. He doesn't want to get in there. And now he calls the ball back. It looked like it was after the play. They got inside the three-yard line. We're looking at third and long here. So I don't know what these guys are doing out here. I don't think the refs are having the best day either.
No.
So it's going to be third and long here. I don't know if this is a replay of the down or the timing was very odd there. And Coach Junter doesn't understand it either. He's trying to explain it. Just shaking his head on the other side here. So we're going to come back. It looks like it's going to be third and long with about 2 minutes to go after a huge run by Fleming. And it gets called back. Some crazy going.
We're going to have to offsetting penalties. Both players are ejected from the game. And
yeah, they moved them out of the game, the kids. But it looked like it was well after the play. And it's going to be third down here. They still haven't figured it out. We'll have to check this one on the tape later, Brian. I don't know if we're going to see any. The only evidence we're going to see is a grown man watching two kids not get in the middle of their fights. Foolish. Third and 15 here, replaying that down. Troy Pollock is going to throw. He throws underneath, and Jeremy's there. Oh! He had a curl back and almost made a really nice athletic play there.
Just so
Rosh was open. He went down. He just couldn't make the grab, and it's going to be fourth and probably this has got to be four down territory here, but I tell you, Chelmsford's still within a score here, and that's dangerous territory the way this game's gone. You got to think that if Lucas kicked it through the end zone here, that it's going to be not really a net gain, so they're going to go for it here. Lucas is going to keep it, and he gets wrapped up immediately, gets pushed back. And Chelms is going to take over on the 32-yard line with not much time to go, but these guys can throw the ball. And let's hope that Redding hasn't put themselves in a position here to get hurt. But crazy, crazy play. I'd have to look at that one again where Lucas looks like he went in for the first down inside the four. And once again, it's penalties or whatnot that are going to push the Rockets back. And it's going to be first down here. And you're going to look for three pass plays here. There has to be just a few minutes left in this game. And the Rockets are going to have to be, they got Damari and Pollock back deep. So here we go with a few minutes to go. Here's a last chance here for Chelmsford. Number 14 got a great arm for Chelmsford. He's set up in a formation to throw. This one's actually a handoff up the middle, and he's still on his feet, number seven. Wow, we're thinking throw automatically. They do an inside handoff. He takes it for a first down. So right to the 45-yard line. They even faked us out, Bry.
Yeah.
They must have more time than they think here. You wouldn't think they're keeping it on the ground, but we can't really tell how many timeouts they have here. They're telling them to hurry up with the clock.
Clock is rolling.
1 minute and 25 seconds left in the game here, first down. Maybe they don't have any timeouts. Who knows? That's the time you'd think you'd want to throw the ball, though. Nice catch there, but he gets met almost immediately, and that's going to be, oh, the ball's in the ground, and the Rockets come in and pick it up. Wow.
Nice.
A bounce finally goes Redding's way, and who's there? Number 11. I think that was Jeremy Rosh. It's hard to see here. They're actually high-fiving some other guys, maybe Damari. We'll look at that one on tape, but I tell you, at the very end of this game, the Rockets finally get the one bounce to go their way, and they take over possession here. And I think this may be enough for them just to hold on. Huge turnover there, the last effort for Chelmsford. The Rockets are going to take over here and squeak out of Chelmsford with a very ugly win here, Bri. A win's a win, though.
Very,
we'll take it.
Very ugly.
They had some really nice drives, you know, running Fleming and Damari early. Some great pushes into the red zone and turned the ball over a few times. A lot of penalties on both sides of the ball. And you might see these guys content to just keep it and kneel on it, and they do. I think that might be, that's all they're going to do is Troy Pollock is going to kneel on that ball. And I think that's going to be the end of the game here, and it is. So, wow, the Rockets escaping a tight one here. Could have let, you know, they let these guys hang around, and they do win. And we'll take it, right? 4-1 for the Rockets going forward. But once again, that's 2 weeks in a row. We're going to take care of the ball here, Brian. Against a real good team, they're going to make you pay. And fortunately, Chelmsford didn't make them pay this week. Next week, we are traveling out to, I believe, Leominster, Mass?
I believe so.
Leominster, Mass, for a big trip out to Northern Middlesex. Haven't seen those guys before. I think they're a 2-1 or a 3-1 team, too. So the Rockets knock off the formerly unbeaten Chelmsford team here, and they squeak away with a victory. And we will see you next week. Thanks.